Can we have the next question from the brothers? If there are no non-Muslim and reverts, then a Muslim can ask. But I prefer, see, most of the questions are coming out of the topic.
My question you is, straight to the topic.
Sorry?
Straight to the topic.
Straight to the topic. Okay, straight answer. Ask question, straight.
Okay, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Sofian Hadi. I come from Sumbawa, West Nusa Tenggara. I am a teacher. According to your speech, that religion in right perspective, the Christian, the Hindus, and the Buddha, actually, in their holy book, they never claim that there is another God, it's only one God. So, now Hindus, Jews, they actually worship, just like Hindu, they worship snake, or trees, or cows, and who teach them to worship that? And also the Christian, who teach them to worship Jesus Christ? I think that's my question. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
The brother has asked a very straight question, very good question, very important question. If I quoted so many verses from the Jewish scriptures, from the Christian scriptures, from the Hindu scriptures, that God is one, worship Him alone, why do they worship wrong gods? Why do the Christians worship Jesus Christ, peace be upon Him? Why do the Hindus worship the snake? The reason is, who teaches them? It is the church which teaches them. It is the Christian church, the Catholic church, which says, this is mentioned in the Bible. So I tell them, give me proof. So they say, don't go to lectures of Dr. Zakir Naik. Why? It is the church which teaches them wrong things. That's the reason I said that if you want to understand Christianity, don't look at the Christians. Don't follow the church. Follow the Bible. So if you ask the church, therefore I said, I challenge any Christian, any father, any priest, any pope, any doctor of divinity, that if they can point out a single verse, an unequivocal verse, an unambiguous verse from anywhere in the Bible where Jesus Christ, peace be upon Himself, says that I am God, or where He says, worship me, I am ready to accept Christianity. I've been saying this since the last 15 years, 20 years. No one so far has come forward. And that's the reason when Christian with an open mind hear, they come and they accept what I'm saying. Same thing with the Hindus. The Vedas is the most highest book. It is against idol worship. There were many reformers. Where did I get this all from? What I say in my lecture, it is from the Hindu reformers. Dayanand Saraswati, Raja Ram Mohan Roy, Justice Ranade, all these were great reformers who came and told the Hindus, go back to your Vedas. But then they want to read other scriptures. Go back to the Upanishad, they want to read other scriptures. So the other people, the religious leaders, they don't want them to go to the scripture. Why? If they go to the scripture, then who will go to the religious leader? How will they make money? Therefore, I tell, ask your religious leaders, Dr. Zakir Naik, joker-looking person, wearing a cap and having a beard. He is telling the Veda says, Na tasya patima asti, of that God there is no image. They issue a circular, they tell the government, stop Dr. Zakir Naik from speaking in India. Otherwise, most of the Hindus will become Muslim. So the government is after me now, calling me a terrorist, calling me doing money laundering. When they cannot come on the stage to debate, they use other tactics. You know, most of the Western countries are banned from entering. Why? Because they are afraid. They are afraid of this man, thin man. Because they speak the truth. They are afraid that if the Hindus go back to the Veda, they will stop idol worship. And when they go back to the scripture, the Hindu scripture say, there is a last avatar to come, a final messenger to come, the Kalki avatar mentioned in Kalki Purana, chapter number 2, verse number 5, verse number 7, verse number 15, that the last messenger to come, his father's name shall be Vishnu Yas. Vishnu Vyas means servant of Allah, Abdullah. His mother's name will be Sumati, meaning serenity, peace, Amina. He'll be born in the city of peace, Makkah. He'll be born in the family of the leaders of Makkah, Quraysh. He'll have four companions, the four Khulafa Rashideen. He will get the revelation in a cave, Gar-e Hira, at night time. He will migrate northwards and come back. Prophet migrated to Medina and came back. Where it is mentioned? Hindu scriptures. Kalki Purana, Bhavishya Purana. Our job is to spread the message of truth. Whether they accept or not, it's in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you now, when you hear, you should repeat to your Hindu friend, to your Christian friend. Tell them, why don't you follow your scripture? Ta'ala ila kalimatin sawa imbayna wa baynakum. Come to common terms as between us and you. Have a dialogue. And it's the duty of every Muslim to convey the message of Islam to those who are not aware of. Hope that answers the question, brother.